I'm here with Harry Pearce from Pentagram. He's come all the way from the UK to semi-permanent 09. And, well, how's it going so far?
It's been lovely. It's been great. It's been wonderful just kind of being amongst this gathering of all these extraordinary people, from the people I've met in the audience to the speakers. The conversations have been fantastic. It's been a real delight. It's been real inspirations. Everything's been so kind of wonderfully different. It's great. It's great seeing other people's ways they kind of make their lives in this thing called creativity, I suppose.
So it's not only an event for all the people in the audience to be inspired by the designers speaking, but the designers who are speaking can be inspired by each other as well.
Yeah, I think you just learn so much from each other. It's a great way of growing personally too, to be a part of this and be able to kind of rub up against people who do things in such a different way to you. It makes you rethink how you do your own stuff, so it's great.
Yeah. Absolutely. And so tell us a little bit about your work. You specialise in, you do a lot of spatial design.
Well, my work's, I specialise in the fact that it's very varied, but I suppose there's a theme of typography that runs through all of it. But I do everything from kind of identities to, graphics within space. I do a lot of human rights work, which I've been doing all my career, but for the last 15 years I've been dedicated to this one project with Peter Gabriel called Witness. It's been a part of me and my team forever, and when I joined Pentagram it just naturally carries on. But we do it entirely for free, and sometimes have one or two people in the team working full time on it.
Tell us a little bit more about what the Witness program is about.
Oh, it's an extraordinary thing. Peter Gabriel had this idea, so it's been running 15 years now, so say 16 years, 17 years ago, he had this idea that if Little Brother could turn the cameras back on Big Brother, what an amazing thing that would be, because you could really hold people to account, governments and bodies of force to account, because the evidence would be there. And everyone thought it was a kind of bit of a kind of crazy rock star idea. And then there was the Rodney King beating in LA. I don't know if you remember that, where the police were caught on camera beating the crap out of a guy, and it brought LA to its knees. I mean, it was an extraordinary kind of history-making moment. And out of that, the Reebok gave him $1 million, and they had some other sponsorship, and suddenly Witness was born. And the essential idea is it's about cameras of all sorts. I mean, it's gone from the handheld camera, cameras like your camera, right down to, you can do it on a telephone now. And it's just about allowing people who have no voice to tell their stories and connect with people mainly through a website called The Hub, to get support and to kind of affect change for the better. It's extraordinary, some of the things it's managed to achieve. It's quite amazing. I guess I've learned that leading a creative life is a profound privilege. If you can make a life out of that, you're kind of growing and having a great time. It's about growth and creativity forever. And if to have the privilege of that is so extraordinary, I think you have to balance it with something else. And I guess my inspirations come from the way Peter balances his kind of musical world with his human rights world, and there's many other projects he's involved in. And this is my kind of humble attempt to balance my life. So I think everyone has to find their own way, whether corporations individually or whatever, and I wouldn't be one to sort of say you should all go and do this, but I think if it's in you then and you can balance it. I never had the money to be able to give anything of substance to this, but I can give my work. So that's how I, it's kind of a balance.
Have you actually managed to speak to anyone at the event today, any of the audience? And
I think once after I've spoken, I'll have a chance, because people will kind of connect the stories with the person a little bit more, so I'll be able to...
You'll be bombarded.
Maybe. But I've spoken to lots of people. I had the most wonderful, surreal conversation about death with Radar last night. So you never know where you get, conversations just... You come to places like this, you meet friends you haven't seen for ages, you make new friends. It's fantastic.
Is Radar a good value to hang out with?
He's great. He's brilliant. And I think that whoever had the idea of him kind of comparing this, there's never a low between the speakers, and it's just the end. It just keeps the energy and the continual up feeling right on, on the money. And he's superb. He's brilliant. Oh, that's fantastic. Just really interested to see what he says about me before I go on anything.
Now that he's got to know you a bit more last night and whatnot.
See, I don't know. We talked about Spike Milligan and Death and Gravestone, so God knows where he's going to go with that. Could be.
I'm sure he'll find a creative way of merging them together.
Yeah.
Great, Harry, thanks for speaking to us. Enjoy, good luck this afternoon with your talk.
Being here, thank you so much. Cheers.